going to be LMU.
Long day today, Riv.
Yeah.
Very exciting, though.
Long day and a long week.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Let's keep that adrenaline pumping. Brom, Elise, banned out. Kassadin, probably a Kale coming out on this side.
Oh,
who knows?
You're making a bold claim there, Riv.
Maybe.
Maybe a Lulu makes her way into the ban screen after a repeated success of Lulu so far.
Lisa.
Especially versus Jax. Junglers, definitely. You know, we have one Elise ban. That signals either somebody's first pick in Lee Sin. See him happy.
Oh, yeah.
And always like to see him on Yasuo. He is one of the most impressive North American Yasuo players out there. And he's already got several ways to set up his ultimate. So very, very easy ulties for Yasuo going to come in for the late game.
Unfortunately, he's only gotten two chances to play it since it's always banned out against them. But those plays have been absolutely amazing. 11-2-6 and 5-1-11. So watch out. Could be forced onto an Eve here. Not too bad of a champion for Dominate to be on, but he's got to be careful. And hopefully Curse doesn't fall behind, because their ability to get Eve in a situation of side ganks, getting back into a game, isn't that great.
And with Eve locked in, that means that Gragas is secured for the top lane.
Right, yeah,
good
call.
That will be a Quas on Gragas. Now, Gragas is fairly similar to Mundo, who is one of Quas's favorite champions. However, Gragas is much more utility-oriented and much more mid-game-oriented. He's not as strong as a tank as Mundo, however, brings much more utility to the team and a much earlier power spike than Mundo. Mundo really looking at that late game to become the tank of all tanks, whereas Gragas has this mid-game window where he is really, really strong. He can throw his weight around and really dictate the early pace of the game. Wow, boy, boy. Bouncing over a couple of strong Yasuo counters here. Both of those are very strong Yasuo counter picks. Akali is one that he's used before, yet he goes with neither.
Goes with the Ryze. See how it changes. Ryze was recently, I'd say a patch or spring ago. Split, not a patch. Wow, words are easy. In the top lane. So now Void Boy bringing that to the mid lane. We saw Poebelter drawing bans on it. We'll see if they can scale it into the late game, because they got Cog, they got Ryze. Gragas gets pretty big as well in those fight compositions, and he can be a big guy. Up against that kill team, though, of LMQ, that is going to be a lot of early pressure.
Yes. Can a Ryze and Kog'Maw team make it through the beginning of this game? If they can, it's a very, very good omen for that team.
Dodge bullets.
However, we saw EG fail with a very similar comp. They had Gragas, they had Ryze, and they had Kog'Maw, and they couldn't pull it out in the end game with only two threats.
Well, let's take a look at the poll on LOLesports.com to see who you think will take the W. It's 76% going to LMQ right now. And that can change.
Don't forget, you can change that yourself by sending in your picks to @LOEsports. Use the hashtag LMQWin or CRSWin. And we will update that poll shortly.
And I'm not going to lie. I'm loving the long games because it's giving us standard lanes. And I like to see how everybody matches up 1v1.
Uh-huh.
Who can create the most pressure in the early game. So let's keep it going. These teams have played up to 35 and 47 minute games. So we're looking for another long haul here.
You're already just putting it out there. I mean, we've got Ryze and we have Kog'Maw, so some of the teams are looking for a bit longer of a game. But LMQ, really strong early and mid-game power spikes here. Renekton, Lee Sin, Corki, all of these early game, mid-game bullies, they're going to push as far as they can in this early game. And the only problem for them is that after they've gotten these early leads, which have been fairly easy for them to secure, they then overreach with a tower dive.
Right.
And that's where the teams with the later scaling champions have turned it around on them in the past.
Everything kind of falls into place in this game. LMQ's good at taking an early lead. Curse is a team that's good when they're behind in gold. They're able to win fights. So we'll see if that plays into their favor.
Yeah, it's a really interesting matchup, actually, because LMQ are the team to make a move. Mm-hmm. Curse are the team, they don't like making moves anymore. They want to wait for their opponents to do just that and capitalize on any mistake that their opponents do make. So it's really just about, we are pretty sure LMQ is going to be the one making the moves early. Yeah. Are they going to be successful? Because Curse are looking to turn those around.
Seems like you need to play the freak style of game where you let them get a bunch of kills and then you just take the money back.
Is that freak strategy?
All day.
He builds up the
yeah.
the kill bounties on his opponents.
And then you take it.
And then take it back.
Oh, that okay. mind game. But no, it's something LMQ does. You kind of picture it in your head as they're diving down at the bottom tier, second tier turret, and then they do it again. And then they come back to do it again, and that third time is when they get caught. Those are the mistakes we're talking about. Like you said, they always think they can get a little too much. Here, we're going to get no invades for the start of the game. Everybody's being pretty nice and easy.
Yep.
15 minutes, no run.
We'll see. Defensive start here for Curse. They've metered out their wards down this river to see if there are any delayed invades. Standard lanes, you get your wish, Riv.
Yeah.
We'll be a little bit slower of a game. I really am going to pay attention to this top lane matchup because I'm very interested to see how well Quas can do with Gragas. I like Gragas in this matchup, actually. With the nerfs to Doran Blade, they actually really hurt Renekton a lot. Not only is the health hit, the damage was hit,
right.
and the sustain was hit because it's only lifesteal now, and you get way less than 5 per hit. But Renekton used to rely on, every time he activates his W, that's 2 more procs of the Doran Blade, and every time it's a power, that's 3 more procs. Now it's only a pittance with a small amount of lifesteal. His sustain was actually hit substantially. Whereas Gragas, his passive is going to do a lot of sustain. Renekton will have to rely on that cold meek.
Great trade in the early game. Sustain in the bottom lane. Ooh. Coming up a double phosphorus.
Value right there, Riv. Value.
Real
bomb.
Value. Twofer.
Rename that ability.
To value?
Value bomb.
That's pretty weak.
That's pretty bad.
Phosphorus. Make it stinky.
Rat-a-tat-tat bomb. Seems all right. Silly. So the harass early coming out from LMQ as expected. Corki, Nami. Extremely strong, and they've got the side bush control. It's very easy to tell who's dictating the bottom lanes, which support is able to get that side bush control, especially in matchups like Thresh versus Nami,
right.
who have windups to their skill shots. Very easy for them to land from the bushes. Very difficult to dodge when you don't see the windup coming. We'll see if they can make Koppenik Special pay, but Koppenik Special are used to this style of play. Defensive style opening up.
Right.
They just want to see us through this mid game, through this early game.
Kiwi Kid and Cutie Pie talking about take advantage of that defensive style. And so far, Vasili and Moore have pushed in. Only a 5 CS lead, but that can start to be that level 3-4.
Dives this early on are very dangerous, especially against Thresh. Thresh can interrupt the Lee Sin travel time when he goes for the second activation of Q.
Waiting for Dominate to come around, but he's on the top side, maybe?
Yeah, it would have. Yeah. He's waiting for the counter gank,
right.
but Dominate does not usually go to gank Curse bottom lane. I think that was maybe a failure in scouting from LMQ. Mm. Dominate, he usually lets Kopp and Xspecial play defensively and leaves them down there to that game. So no gank from him.
Right, if you're going to play defensive and know you're not going to be in trouble.
What a wow.
Sonic Wave at the max range. They can't get too much off, but the flash will be enough for a return trip here in a few minutes. Hook missed out by Xspecial. You can see as we were talking about the ward control in that side bush. No one really has it.
Great shot from No Name there. Able to get out that Void Boy flash very early on. Void Boy's going to have to purchase Vision to protect himself now. He opted for the pink ward instead of trying to get multiple greens. Maybe didn't have enough for the duo of greens. Needs to also keep himself supplied with biscuits to sustain through the Yasuo harass. However, on this rise, running exhaust. That is something you don't see too often. Really what he's worried about is the all-in. Once Yasuo comes in, if you ult him during that, or if you exhaust him during that ult, wow, No Name back to bottom. What a hook, but they have No Name in the vicinity, so you can't do anything about it.
Got the flash out. Very nicely done there. We'll have to see if they can return, like you were saying. The exhaust, it'll be pretty helpful, but it's got to have a good target to hit it on, because if you have No Name and Xiao Wei Xiao on you, you might be dead anyways. Good choice there, though.
No Name spending so much time down here. No Name has not been in his jungle for a good 2 solid minutes, up and down this river, and look at that gold lead from Dominate. He's got 10 CS lead on No Name.
Stone
level
already.
5.
Yep.
No Name still down here. He is not giving up.
This is going to give Dominate a perfect chance to come!
No!
Right into the turret! This is going to be first blood! Cop flash is in. Where's the defensive play from Curse now? They're going headstrong aggro onto this. A good move coming in. Cop does finally go down to Kathy in surprise. The double kill for him.
You gotta give it to Cop. He's making great use of that passive on Kog'Maw. That
Heck
is
yeah.
strong passive play there from Kog'Maw. Gets the double kill with it.
What I do want to see is more players using the fanfare when you're in a cat.
Look at Expecto here. Dodges the bubble, gets the perfect play into tower range, lands the crooked hook, stays alive.
Boom.
And Cop wants the kill, so he flashes forward. Maybe a little bit of greed there to wait for Dominate. But he does get the double kill for his efforts. Starting off that Kog'Maw strong is going to be really big for them. And man, we said,
yeah.
Dominate does not usually gank this bottom lane, but if No Name is down there for a minute straight,
right.
maybe three successive ganks down there, and he just draws the attention of Dominate, who had been farming the whole time, who's level 5, huge lead on him, item advantage as well. And once Dominate came to join the party, X-Special comes up with a huge play yeah. down bottom and makes No Name regret his stay in the bottom lane.
The one last thing I want to see from Kog'Maw players is that they do use the fanfare when they're dying. You can still press Control-1. When you're running around, it's a great thing to do.
Is it?
Taunt your foes while you're about to blow up on them. 2-1, 7.5 into this game. What looked like was going to be trouble in the bottom lane kind of picked up from Curse. Get Cop going a little bit earlier in this one. He's definitely on a long late game AD carry. If he can get Kog'Maw fed up quite well, we'll see a different style of play from him.
I like this move from Dominate. Summoners are blown down bottom. He is Evelyn, so it's very easy for him to get into a gank.
Right.
Pink Ward is in the Tribush, though, so as long as he doesn't wrap around that, he should be able to get in here for an ultimate, get the slowdown for an easy hook for X-Special. Now, the other thing about No Name camping bottom is he leeched experience from the bottom lane for a long time as well. So while he is level 6, equal with Dominate, he hurt the bottom lane,
yeah.
stealing experience from Vasili and more. As if dying wasn't enough to get them behind, they're also going to be behind in experience down there. But again, true to Vasili's style, he's on Corki, he's bullying, he shove it right back up into Curse's face.
Well, if you have the wards, you make sure they don't use the pressure they just got, and they're forced to use all their attacks and abilities under the turret, keeping them safe. The sustain from Morn Vasili keeps them in the mindset that they can keep playing strong. Pink wards from behind, but they're actually not going to see this regular ward that Dominate's about to walk over. See if they actually decide. They are playing very aggressive.
This is a long cooldown on Valkyrie, one of the longest cooldowns for a dash of an AD carry. Dominate should just run in there and go ultimate. The cooldown, after it was just used, and Vasili's right up there. This hesitation is a little bit much. I guess he's waiting for the hook for X-Special to come back up, but
oh.
wow! X-Special does it himself! He doesn't wait for
Dominate. He plays him into the box wall! That's Cops coming up clean. The bubble goes out, and they wait. Nice guy. And he holds on for X-Special. The Thresh Express almost able to capitalize on some damage
Again,
from Vasili, but that's Dragon.
That was all X-Special right there. They didn't even need Dominate for that kill. Great hook straight onto Nami. No Name comes a little bit late to the party, but he's got double buffs Lee Sin. Formidable early game foe. Yasuo has just been forced back to base, though. What perfect timing for Curse to grab that kill. Two-man defense for LMQ. Can they go for a steal? Unlikely.
No, this is going to be a easy Dragon going over to Curse. Plays coming from X-Special.
Oh!
Great ultimate. Watch out for Dominus. He's going to be able to trade back as well as sustain. And if Quas can't get his abilities off, that passive won't be helping too much. So they kind of go even on the trade with alts being used both sides.
Yeah. Guess we learned a little bit about that matchup.
Yeah.
Ackerman performing very well on his Renekton. Good CSing under turret there by Voidway with the Flux. We'll see though. We have drawn some attention to Quas. After that last exchange, Ackerman called up reinforcements. Nice. Zones him off of that minion. It's a small things. Xiao Xiao went through a ward. Doesn't care.
Ooh. Just a love tap from Dominate. Didn't really want anything.
Scare him off.
A lot of pressure in that top lane. LMQ had 3 members. Knowing that Dragon's down, they're kind of objective free, so they're trying to get something out of that. But
yeah.
Nicely thwarted by Curse.
Curse, really good answer there.
Yeah.
Voidboy on Ryze, trying to get his mana items to scale. Tier stacking up. He went with early tabby. It delays his Rod of Ages a little bit. However, it's completely worth it because it blocks so much damage from Yasuo.
Slow move in here for LMQ. With Curse having the lead, we'll see how they play this. This is exactly what we talked about in the beginning. Curse is a very good team at playing from behind, but they get themselves into trouble when they do have the lead. They take even more than LMQ tries to take when they have a lead, and it really backfires hard.
All right. That logic only goes so far, though, because you'd always rather have the lead. So I'm still,
this is true.
They're still pretty happy.
This is true.
With having the lead earlier, especially Cop, who's, you know, they're playing defensive down there. He's really happy to have those
It's a different pace. Definitely a different pace for the lead to be on Cop right
Man,
now.
No name back to bottom, though. So much ward control bottom. It doesn't matter to Lee Sin because he's created lane ganks. He could safeguard in there for something. But even with three kills, this Curse bottom lane plays defensively. They play safe. So I don't think No Name really counted on the style of this bottom lane when he planned out his early jungle pathing.
Right. Because it's seen. He is walking through a security system right now, and Curse is going to know if he ever comes near bottom. This is keep playing safe. Good pressure on mid turret. Xiaowei Xiao is trying to get this down so he can roam.
Now, No Name going to invade here. He is at a severe disadvantage if he meets Evelynn. Dominate already has completed Lizard Elder, whereas he's sitting on double longswords here. No Name is extremely poor, but he gets the deep ward down with no retaliation from Curse.
Little things that could possibly help to make a move when they need it, whether it's going to be a dive on Void Boy or just control of the next blue buff that leads to a dragon. So many possibilities. Easier said than done. Can LMQ act on what they are trying to put in position? Good damage on the bottom tier turret. They're winning in the lane pressure right now, but they don't seem to have control of the map. Now they're starting to gain control of that map. Now they're trying to shut down Dominate. There's the dive we were just talking about. The forward wards pay off immediately.
That combo, Lee Sin Yasuo, is a very popular one. A lot of burst damage for Evelynn, even though Dominate gets off his ulti, not able to survive. And is going to be big for Xiaowei Xiao, because he already had Static Shift, which is a big spike.
There's a grab from the bottom lane.
Man, Xspecial is just carrying this bottom lane really, really
hard.
Hey,
man. All-star support came from that Thresh. Xspecial's mechanics on Thresh, just over and over again. He's still got it.
I mean, it's making it hard, you know. Vasili here on Corki wants to be able to bully Kog'Maw early. That's the whole point of this Corki pick, is his early and mid-game prowess, the power that he has over Kog while they're scaling up. But now, Kog'Maw completed Trinity Force. That has pretty much been evened out. It's already 14 minutes here. Cops should not be getting pushed around any longer.
No. Look at that scoreboard, 2-4. When you look at the bottom lane of Curse, 4 kills on Cop, 4 assists on Xspecial, working it very well in that bottom lane. And Dominate was there for 2 to participate in those. You can tell, looking at the inventories, Curse is definitely looking for the long haul. Rod of Ages to be stacked up as well as the tier with your Kog'Maw late game.
Meanwhile, top lane, Kwasa has crawled back, only a few CS down to Ackerman, and he's scaling up fairly well here, getting some armor in now.
Oh, well.
To supplement his early AP buys. Not going for the early completion of that Rod of Ages, though. He's sitting on the catalyst, so remember, it takes 10 minutes after you actually complete the item for it to build up. When you first buy it, it's actually not very efficient.
These guys going pretty hard. 30 seconds on Dragon, so they're trying to spit out what damage they can.
Look at
the forward wards from LMQ now, once again to be used. They have breadcrumb wards for safety in the jungle they praised previously.
And this Xiao Xiao Yasuo, there was not even a tenth of a second there for the animation for Xspecial to move from the Lee Sin kick. As soon as it registers, boom, Xiao Xiao's there, stuck in place, and he saves the dash to jump over the wall after Xspecial flashes. Really, really well played by Xiaowei Xiao. And Xspecial with the first misstep here. Again, supports trying to get vision. It's a dangerous game for them.
Absolutely. So what LMQ has prioritized completely pays off in the last 3.5 minutes. They made quick work of that to now completely even out the game. They're only down a kill. And I'm sure they'll find that somewhere very soon. They're still continuing to put wards down in that bottom side of the jungle.
And Vasili, since he has foregone the purchasing of boots, he's been able to rush the completion of his Trinity Force.
Yeah. And pinks for his team.
So that will be very big for their bottom lane. And they continue to push Cop and Xspecial back. But man, 4 kills for Curse, 4 assists on Xspecial. Every single one was set up by him. 4 kills for Cop. It's where they want the money.
Yep.
But can he make use of it? Kog'Maw, the reason I think that it took so long to make its way over to North America is it's a bit different than most of the other AD carries. It's not the easiest to play because you have to be very quick with your mouse.
Yeah.
He does long range damage, so your target selection is very far away from your champion, and you have to move your cursor a relatively large distance.
Right.
But he's also very low mobility, and dodging skill shots is paramount on him. He cannot get locked down, so you have to move your mouse back to your character for a quick dodge in the right direction.
It's a different style. If you think of somebody like Doublelift, if he were to play Kog'Maw, Doublelift locks his screen in a fight. You can't do that with Kog'Maw's living artillery at max range. You're missing out on range, so he is absolutely a different player. Champion, I should say. Let's see what the late game can provide from him, and we'll see if Cop actually has that ability to lift the living hit the living artillery. It's a slow falling spell, pretty easy to dodge out, so it's almost like you are the AD carry that gets to predict the skill shots this time. They're dodging yours.
Yeah, it's really hard to dodge if you don't have boots, but now Vasili has been able to get tier 2. Going with the Sork boots for more poke damage rather than the auto attack oriented Berserker Greed. So right now, let's see if Xiao Xiao gets caught.
Yeah, he's definitely caught. Oh, the windmill's a little far, but the team gets a very nice tidal wave from Nami. That is a great last breath to follow up, and it's a little back and forth, but No Name and the rest of the team are just trying to decide who to kick. A Rune Prison saves down Void Boy, but he's out of the fight. Nobody is going to be taking the Lantern. Quas has to run back to the turret. He actually might be safe here. No, the Resonating Strike that Sonic Wave didn't hit. He actually may have gotten help from the rest of his team.
Xspecial trying to get there to offer his support to the rest of the Curse squad, but nobody takes the Lantern out. And it's going to be Void Boy dead, actually.
Void Boy gets it up. The Ignite coming in to make sure they could finalize that. Staying a little too long. Did not need to ward there, but they now know the red's gone.
Yeah, perfect Nami play. Land the slow first. Flash in bubble. Great job by him. Double Rod of Ages have been completed, so both solo laners from Curse now on that 10-minute timer, working their way up. Great knock-up, so they get two of them in the air. Void Boy flashes over. Let's see.
Yeah.
The hook barely misses. One of the ones that where Xspecial does miss.
Somebody take it.
It's right next to Quad.
Take the Lantern.
It's right next to him. He doesn't see it. His eyes are...
He couldn't see it under his belly.
He's got the beer goggles on.
Yeah, that's all right.
His vision was blurred.
It happens. I'm at fault for not taking Lanterns, too. I can't say anything.
Whoa, Xspecial again. Barely missing out. Catching the coattails.
And that's one great thing about having an awesome game on a champion like Thresh, is your presence starts to create more pressure. If you're having a bad game, teams consider that, and they'll walk around you. But right now, they have to make sure they're not in the range of that hook. Quas, wow, this is a weird separation for the fight. Cop's out of mana. There's a fight going on at the top here, and just down to the south. Cop figures out that he's in a sore spot. Gets back to the team, and they're able to trade 2-for-1 here. Curse's favor so far. Ackerman with a very deep teleport that I don't think they should have done.
We got to give a lot of credit to Quas in that fight. Mm-hmm. He teleports first, he zones out Vasili, knocks him back with the ultimate so that the fight is sectioned off into 2 separate quadrants right there. With a lot of the damage from LFQ not going to the damage sources of Curse. They had him cornered, 4 men up there in the blue side by Golem Bush. Whereas the only member from Curse that was zoned off in the bottom side was Cop. So let's take a look here.
Time. What a spread in this
early
fight.
Teleport in from Quas. He gets a couple seconds jump, and that's all it takes. 2 members of LMQ jump in. So when Quas walks by here, he has already thrown his ulti to make sure Vasili is not going to join. Cobb is able to make his way over by using the speed boost of his heel and then flashing over the side. Zones out, allows his barrel to ferment there for a while for extra damage. He gets the exit kill on Ackerman.
The stinky sauce, right? Just get hit up. You're either slowed by it or you're dead by it. Not fun. Moving up, LMQ is going to be getting a few structures and some gold for themselves, assisted in that area as well. Go back and forth. Xiao Wei Xiao whips out the sword! Tries to make a big move, but he's going to have to dash out of this one. So he's going the wrong way right now. We'll see if he can turn this one back around. And he cannot. The wall goes out. Just a tad to the side.
Not the angle he wanted right there on the wall, but he still would have went down. Anyways, that's why Boy Boy took exhaust right there. Saw it in action. It was able to lower the damage enough. Red buff in it. Quas turns it around.
Yeah. Big, big boy Quas is. Definitely different stats on Gragas now coming into 4.10. And it's going to be a hit up on Ackerman. The barrel almost hits. They do take down Boy Boy. He gets a little too close for comfort. Curse has to reassess this fight. Xiao Wei Xiao still waiting to come back from just before.
I have to say, after the rough early game there from No Name and the countering that he received, he's had some very strong Lee Sin ultimates. He does not stop trying to make plays. As we said, LMQ are a team that keeps swinging!
He can still safeguard out of this one if he gets the ward out, but it looks like they may be able to come out on top of this fight! He hits another beautiful Sonic Wave! Gets the hit down, now on to Dominate! Cop's gonna be able to wreak havoc!
He
missed it, just point blank, but it's only the Void Ooze. Cop actually will not pursue. Xiao Wei Xiao entering the fight, remember, he was just coming from base.
Yep.
LMQ did that with four people.
Xiao Wei Xiao not able to avoid the slow there, though, so his flash goes to waste.
Right.
All right, No Name, as we say, LMQ keeps swinging. He goes for the steal, he gets the steal. Then he turns around and picks up some kills as well. Even with Dominating getting face of the mounted shield, gets the red buff. Now this Q, even if he lands it and goes in on Cop, he probably dies. So, maybe he was just trying to avoid the Lee syndrome. He had gotten a prescription.
Yeah, keeping it safe.
Avoid landing Qs when you are half-life.
Hey man, doctor's orders. Sometimes you gotta listen. So we're getting the charged up here. Let's go ahead and take a look at the inventory on the side of Cross and Boy Boy. Look quite charged, fully charged. Boy Boy's almost there. He'll be up there soon. And Cross is about 60 off. So soon. They're still looking Ninja Tobbies across the board we were talking about earlier. All the damage they're trying to shut down, at least for that impact of Xiao Wei Xiao's hit. But the whole team of LMQ, we know their aggression. It does not stop. And now that they have a lead, it's coming on even stronger. Xiao Wei Xiao wanted a 1v1 immediately there.
They have had a pretty good early game. The only flaw was the concentration down bottom. That didn't work out. But since then, they haven't let up. They don't let, the first stumble slow them down at all. They get right back to it. And they need to. They have to do that with the squad that they've picked. With these champions, they need to take advantage of these spikes in power.
Yeah.
Corki, especially right now, very, very strong.
Another uncontested outer turret. Three now, and it's actually a shutdown for LMQ so far in those turrets. They have not lost any map vision in the lanes.
Yasuo with the two-item power spike. Lee Sin getting the early magic resist aura. Strong for the team in itself because it's a dual AP with a sort of hybrid damage AD carry.
Right. There's a lot of AoE.
Baron already dead. What in the...
Oh, Boy Boy goes in. He doesn't really have what he needs to take the damage from LMQ yet. Quas, however, he does. If that was the first entry, they may be looking at a different fight. They're somewhat able to turn this around. Cobb is very big, but he really hasn't had the time to just spit out damage in a fight. This is the extended fight that they want.
Oh!
Another hook coming in from Xpecial, one after the other for Curse this game.
Interesting trade there. I believe they also killed... No, they did not kill Ackerman. He got out with the Baron buff.
Yeah, just one.
So yeah, early start from LMQ. No Name screens until Baron gets low, gets down there. Boy Boy rushes in for the AoE magic damage. after LMQ sit and Baron pit, very, very effective. Him plus Quas were able to do enough. Yeah, Ackerman does escape down the bottom. But Curse don't let anyone else. Taking down both No Name as a, there we go. Another one of the hooks. So yeah, how much were Curse able to get during that replay? I don't think there was much left on the map.
Well, they've got one Dragon's turret so
dead
far.
Now.
So they grab mid.
They may have got, yeah, they got one turret at least. Right. Think Dragon was still down for that. But yeah, a pretty good recovery by Curse there to scrape up some kills and then an objective. The global gold there and mid turret being down may have drawn that to even. Because there's only two Baron buffs left on LMQ. It's not the end of the world there for Curse. Even though Vasili on Corki is one of the best champions to have that Baron buff on, he benefits from all aspects of the buff. And he's
very
already,
whoa,
early Last Whisper, actually, to get through all of these Ninja Tabi and the sort of tanky Gragas, the Frozen Heart from Boy Boy. I think it's a good buy. There's a lot of early armor here on Curse. So nice early purchase there from Vasili. Make sure that he does have this mid-game Corki power spike and make sure that he can take advantage of it. The double Rod of Ages are almost built up.
Very close.
Fully stacked up for Quas. Boy Boys just ticks home to 200 as well. So they have the scaling from their rods as well.
It doesn't make them
look
huge, though.
Looking to make plays.
See if they can get bigger here. 6-1 and 4 cop definitely needs a little bit of peel from the team coming into this next fight. See if he can keep himself safe. He's also going for the Last Whisper in the next purchase. He has the longsword pickaxe. We see, like you said, armor coming out for everybody. Special already having that, probably going for Randuin's in the chain vest build he's put in for himself. We'll see that coming out for Quas as well. Curse now a little on the back foot, even though they won that fight. Still waiting for LMQ to go into let's make a mistake mode. But
I mean,
if LMQ doesn't do that, it could be quick.
This right now is probably the most crucial point in the game because Lee Sin is starting to fall off. He's pretty much full utility now. Got the locket, and he's going to have to make some plays with his Sightstone. Renekton starting to go that way as well. Just with the Tiamat, Quas is actually a fairly big impact on these mid-game team fights, and the Ryze is going to continue to go that way. Until
indecisive.
Yasuo caps out, though, they still have increased power here for LMQ. Dragon taken.
They didn't see him the whole time, and they let them finish Dragon before they engage, so their focus can be spot on. But will it matter? Xiaowei Zhao going down very fast. There's a lot of focus from him. Vasili's got himself in a great position, and so does Cobb. The AD carries are shredding from the outside. Vasili's got himself on the other side of the wall and can't return, as now Curse is three strong.
The prediction!
Gets it! The prediction is indeed with the living artillery. Cobb comes up huge.
Yeah, you gotta give Cobb credit for that one. Beautiful shot, even before the ward is placed. Knows exactly what No Name is going for. And Vasili, the reason he had to flash out into Dragon Pit is because he Valked into the fight right next to Boy Boy.
Right.
You cannot Valkyrie right next to that late game. Well, it's not late game, Ryze, but even mid game. He's got his completed items. Very dangerous. LQ, full aggression. Vasili, for the beginning of the fight, is shoving all of his damage into Quas. There's the Valk into Boy Boy here.
Whoops.
And he knows, whoopsies, got to flash out. That's a lot of LQ damage. They don't have that mid game Corki to deal with the rest of this fight, so there's nothing left for him. Shot fired, ward placed, bad choice. There's another angle. He could have gone down there with a ward jump. But man, cop with the prediction. Good pickup for Curse. And that's 8 kills now for him. This Kog'Maw is going to get out of control. Boy Boy just finishes the Seraph's Embrace on the Ryze 2. This is the problem that LMQ were worried about running into. They still do have a little bit of breathing room, though. Because Yasuo has the 3 items, the very, very strong completion of Infinity Edge on top of the first two here. So Xiaowei Zhao will have a strong impact, but man, they pretty much need to make a quick move.
Yeah. They got to get through a lot too. Boy Boy is able to control Seraph's Embrace Shield now, so he can give himself a little mitigation on that front end burst that's going to be so heavy coming out of LMQ.
Yeah, the... That duo there, everyone thought, you know, the Renekton and Lee Sin, you feel great about them for the early game.
Yeah.
And even mid, because of the early game gold lead that they got. But Once we get past this 30-minute mark, those...
Uh-oh.
They turn sour. Xspecial takes the ride.
Ackerman, that's a split on the fight. So Xspecial's on the right
versus
side.
Four.
This means there's hardly any peel for Cop, but that, he can't get back.
Oh!
Cop has great positioning right now, so he doesn't even need the peel. Xiao Wei Xiao goes in, and they quickly jump over to Cop, forcing him to flash. LMQ is just waiting to take down Cop. Yeah. That focus did not work for them.
That Rune Prison is all the peel that they needed. Great job by Boy Boy looking out for Cop. Cop for this fight still had both summoners as well.
Yeah.
So it was just a decimation of the LMQ squad here. And the late game Cog, Boy Boy already stacked up. This may be
very good. They still got
the timer expiring
20 seconds
for LMQ.
On Lee Sin, he can provide a little bit of slow and the control they need to keep Curse in a bad spot. But yeah, they have the inhibitor. They have a free walk out of the base without taking anything else. Baron's going to be up in 11 seconds. They might have to worry about that in backing.
So communication there. Quas calling, I've got teleport ready. So Xspecial takes the ride and they get this team fight. Everybody groups up. There was so much damage on No Name. They got him out of the fight really early. Yeah. Since Xspecial still has Face of the Mountain for Cop. Cop with the Kog'Maw, Trinity Force plus Blade build.
Oh, man.
Actually fairly substantially defensive. Ackerman's toast. They actually get Baron and kill Ackerman at the same time. He doesn't go down. Mikhail's gets him out.
Oh no. The Xiao Wei Xiao replay it. Baron, Xiao Wei Xiao
going down.
It's gonna be a triple. First one. Last one was a triple to almost a quadro, but he picks up the double this time.
Oh, you have to run with this.
Down.
They need Ackerman to take this advantage.
A great dodge by Xspecial considering his vision, knowing what they could do to get out of that one alive. Vasily's trying to chase with the blue buff, a big one readied in the chamber for the next shot, but it's not gonna take anybody down.
Split focus there from Curse almost cost them, but they are able to come out of it with the Baron and only a 2-for-1 trade for LMQ. So definitely worth it for Curse this time around. Even though they give up control of the map, minion wave here would be one turret at most if LMQ press it. And it doesn't even look like they will press it.
This was almost some scary deja vu.
Exactly. So split here, Baron plus trying to zone, and they zone long enough to buy time to finish off the Baron. Because they got that answer kill on Ackerman, that was pretty much all they needed. Cop this time, as we said, no summoners left. They're able to get the combo that they want. Yasuo got in, killed Cop. That's the point of Xiao Xiao. That's his number one mission. He was able to get it, but it was just a little bit too late for the team.
We're seeing almost the same game as previously. One team's building all damage, the other one's trying to build all defense and still win the game. Curse has been doing a little bit of the winning on the defensive side now, almost within 700 gold as it ticks up. 19-5 as they have the kills. It seems to be working a little bit in both teams' favor as we're going to go again for the long haul.
Yeah, Curse have a bunch of champions with very strong innate damage just in the champion kit, so they can afford to build them very defensively. That's why Ryze is so strong in the late game because he gets all the damage from his kit and he can build defensively with these mana items that also have defensive stats on them. Same thing for Gragas with the sort of hybrid build tank slash AP and Kog'Maw as well. These items that Kog'Maw gets make him beefier.
Uh-oh,
what? Another hook!
Max Rage coming from Xspecial! This is going to be a kill onto No Name. One last shot from the Bio Arcane Barrage, but Cop's not in range. No Name will still go down in that fight. Moore's going to be hit up. Another consecutive hook from Xspecial coming in. His Thresh play today has been out of this world.
It is safe to say that Curse have weathered the early game storm of LMQ, and skies are sunny now.
Dragon going down, Curse picking up everything they can as they make their way back to base. See this again.
Hey yo,
so
if he missed the first one, there were three more members lined up right behind No Name as well. This is with Baron buff.
Cop is always in.
Oh, Quas!
Back.
Quas whipped his ulti right there into the wall, I think. The crooked wall blocked it.
The things you miss when you're looking at everything else. 3,000 gold was accrued from that, along with the dragon for Curse, as they now push down into the bottom lane. Boy Boy's going to help get a little extra damage on that as he face tanks. He has quite a bit of armor for himself. They're not even worried about it. That's like four shots to the face, only down 200 HP. 21-15, the kills continue to rack up in the favor of Curse, and at one point, LMQ had 3 turrets to Curse's none. Now Curse has 6 turrets to 3.
Special gets locked up.
Oh, Ackerman.
Trading.
The range coming in from Cop right now. He's able to shred on the outside. Special very close. They're going down, but he lives. And it's going to be the rest of the team trying to fight on the bottom side here. That's the entrance push out of base. Good kills coming in from Curse.
They blew the no-name Xiao Xiao combo through. That was Lee Sin, Yasuo, ulti, Onyx special, and he survives it.
One more chance the LMQ could have to stop this. Curse is all over the Nexus turrets, though. It's going to be very hard if LMQ is even able to get another fight for themselves. It's going to come in. Ackerman's getting hit up. He gets locked in. He's going to get taken down, possibly. A few more shots. Xpecial just hits 1,000 assists for an NA LCS support. The first one ever at 36 minutes into this game. Moore is almost going to go down. Xpecial finally dies. MVP threat to the game as he hits his 1,000 assists.
What a story. That was eerily similar to Double Lift.
Yep.
Hitting his record right at the buzzer.
Yep.
And Xpecial really earned it this time around.
Oh my gosh.
He put in so much work to land all of those hooks. The assists record definitely deserved from him.
Hooks on hooks. All day long, a very well-fought game. LMQ coming out with an in-your-face composition, looking to get Yasuo procced ultimates almost out of every single lane, but it just wasn't happening. Control over the jungle from No Name in the early game, but Curse was able to bring it back. Great map movement. Boy Boy bringing out the rise this game, and Curse understanding that their composition kind of needed to go late game, and that's where they brought it, with the Rod of Ages and Cop on Kog'Maw. 12-2-9. His last best score is 8-0-8 on Illusion, so he just kind of went off on this game as well.
Cop definitely doing a good job. You have to give him praise for that prediction ult, if nothing else, for the kill on the No Name. Xpecial.
Thanks, Riv. I want to welcome Xpecial and Cop of Curse to the analyst desk and congratulate Xpecial on your 1,000th career assist. You are the first player in the NALCS to do so, and as it so happens, Cop was the player who actually gave you that final assist, so it's kind of a match made in heaven, right?
Yeah.
How does it feel?
Surprising. I had no idea it was even coming up or anything like that. Unlike Double Lift, I can't say I'm the best, but I like to say that it's been fun. 1,000th, how do you even say it? 1,000th assist? Oh my gosh. Sorry, I'm just like super flustered.
Congratulations, Zuka. Yeah, it was in 100 games too, so exactly right on that mark. So let's just take a step back in that game. Let's go back to Champion Select. You guys first picked the Gragas top. Now, Korea's been trying Gragas top for a while. It hasn't seen the same type of success. We've seen it in EU. It still falls flat. People have tried it here. Why are you guys the first team to actually whip it out and have it work?
Is this our first Gragas game in LCS?
Your first?
Yeah.
As Curse?
Yeah.
I'm not sure.
Not sure. Okay, but regardless, it's really...
Otherwise, it's one of the first wins we've seen.
I think it's the first win. But I think he's a strong pick, and it works well against the traditional bully, Renekton, who typically everyone says wins in all matchups. But Gragas actually does well, actually scales better than Renekton. So in a way, he's actually better in every single way, except that he's slightly harder to play. And that's kind of the problem that we're seeing. Mid-game and late-game, you have to land your barrels, have to land your ultimate. And oftentimes, Yasuo just... He's really annoying to deal with. You get the walls, and you see Braum a lot too. These are champions that can really hurt Gragas' scaling. And I think Quatsis played really well this game. He did fairly well in lane, and team fights he showed up and just wrecked people, and it showed, and we won. So that's good.
Remaining in Champion Select, Cop, I want to direct the question to you. You picked the Kog'Maw fairly early, and then we saw Vasili pick up Corki as opposed to, let's say Lucian or Twitch or something like that. And those were on the table. Why do you think that was?
I think Corki's pretty good into Kog'Maw just because he can poke him in lane at level 6, and his early laning is pretty strong against Kog'Maw. So, yeah, they just wanted to take the Nami from us, and so we couldn't get the really strong combo of Kog'Nami. And I don't know, if they play aggressive and get kills, they can snowball on us, but it ended up in our favor.
All right, well, a follow-up on that would be, you managed to have the lane that you wanted, and then it ended up snowballing a couple great hooks and exchanges in the bot lane, and you actually picked up a second kill with your passive on Kog'Maw. Holding all of that gold on a late-game carry like that early, how does that accelerate the game or change the way you guys look at the way you want to play it out?
I think for Kog'Maw, he scales the best, and if you can get an early lead, you can pressure the Corki really hard. So I was able to just take the advantage bottom, and they couldn't really lane against us at all. So we could just snowball bot, and they had to force pressure elsewhere.
Yeah, and we actually are going to bring up a Baron fight on the screen here. It's a little later in the game. You guys go 3-for-1. You do give up Baron, but Xpecial, walk me through this fight.
This was not a good situation for us. We saw that Renekton was preparing to go into Baron, and we knew that they're on Baron. We're trying to check it. We were really far. Grimes TP's in, and it was way too late. But fortunately, they fight, we fight, and we come out ahead. They were just chunked from Baron, and we were strong at this point. We shouldn't have given up Baron, but at least we came out with some kills. It was a fairly close fight, but I came in really late, and we managed to just sweep them. And yeah, we were pretty upset giving them a free Baron, but fortunately, we managed to catch him out. I get a decent hook. She's probably dead anyways, but regardless, I think that was one of my assists that helped me towards that 1,000, so it was worth it.
Absolutely, every single one counts.
A decent hook? That was a really good hook. Your hooks all game in bottom lane, too. You kept hooking more, especially when his flash was down, right into a box.
Yeah, I was actually kind of surprised that they left a Thresh and didn't pick it. Against LMQ in practice, we've often just destroyed them with Thresh. It's one of the few champions actually I feel like I do especially well against, or at least the players. So Thresh, I normally don't carry as hard, and against LMQ especially, I do really well on Thresh. It's kind of surprising. This normally, I don't carry that hard with the champion. I usually do fairly well, but not to this extent. And LMQ has just been a team that is really susceptible to that sort of aggression. And they were forced to pick a weaker lane, and they couldn't play aggressive, and that kind of hurt them. Sure, they had Lee Sin bottom a lot, but Thresh, hooking people in the turret, that's always fun.
All right, Kappa, another question for you. I mean, coming off the backside of that Baron, you were lucky enough to get the Baron buff off of three members. But on an immobile carry like Kog'Maw, how important is positioning at that point, especially as the game scales against a Yasuo and a Lee Sin?
Going into the game, I told my team I really needed a lot of peel, just because Lee Sin, Yasuo, and Renekton are just going to be jumping for me. So it's up to the team to, I guess, protect me and just kill the tanks as they come in, just to ensure that I don't get jumped on.
All right, great. And we're actually going to bring a replay up on your screen. About 31 minutes into the game, this is a fight in the mid lane, and I think it pretty well illustrates your positioning, and you stay alive through the fight, and it's a really great fight. If you could walk me through it real quick.
So here we see Ackerman in the brush, and we can get free damage off, but we really want to focus on the Yasuo, so we notice they're jumping at me, so I tell Voy to spot me with his spines, and then right here, it's just make sure to kill Yasuo and then just kite out the tanks and kill them as they come in, just to protect me pretty much as hard as possible. And with this, we can just, yeah, if we just kite out the tanks and kill them, then we should be able to win.
Yeah, Xiaowei Xiao ended up using his last breath a little too soon on that one, because you got knocked up by it, but ended up just hitting Kwas in that. So a little bit of a save there from Kwas too. But on the other side of this, I want to talk about Curse in the standings right now. You guys are pretty far down there, and you guys can't be happy about your position, but you want to keep climbing. So what's going to separate you from the bottom and get you up into that big pack that seems to be so even right now?
It's been a really rough season for us. We went in like the first week, we were doing extremely well in practice, and we were expecting, you know, top of the standings or like up there. And then we've just not found our ground. Every single game, we would win early game. In terms of just looking at fantasy, which is not a good metric, I know, but it means that we get a lot of turrets, means we get a lot of dragons, at first bloods, etc., but we don't really win games. And that's something that we've been struggling a lot. A lot of it is due to my shot calling just not being as good, and Curse's shot calling has not been good traditionally, and this combination of two is we don't have enough experience as shot callers to really push our mid-game and late-game advantage, which these games are often lasting 30, 40 minutes, which is completely unlike last split, where games were 25 minutes, 30 minutes. Like, that was kind of the latest. And so, late game, not good shot callers, you're going to lose games. And that's something that is relatively easy to fix, but takes time. And as we're progressing through the split, we're going to get better and better at it, but I hope it's not too late.
All right, well, with the standings being as close as they are, really across the board, I have one final question for you, which is, coming off of this win, you've got Cloud9 later today. How do you carry that momentum? What are the next steps into making sure that you do kind of turn things around for the team?
Honestly, this game wasn't even that clean for us. So we need to look at this game, figure out, okay, where are our mistakes in shot calling? Like with that Baron, for example, we need to not do those. We need to be able to push our advantage harder. We were winning early game. we should win the game cleaner. And that's something we still need to strive towards. And honestly, it's still going to be tough. Cloud9's a good team. We haven't beat them once ever, so we would like to have a win now. It could really help us swing our momentum to prepare for next game tomorrow, too.
Fantastic. Well, congratulations again on your 1,000th assist. Good luck in your game later today. Great game that just happened, and we'll see you guys later.
Thank you.
We only just hit the halfway point, but after the break, we'll be reading a few of your favorite Twitter responses. Then it's back to the games with Evil Geniuses versus TSM. Don't go anywhere.